Hi, this is Phil Pendlebury. I'm here with Cubase 10.5 and EZbass. And today we're going to look at using EZbass's articulations within your DAW rather than using the EZbass interface. Okay, so I've got EZbass set up and I've had quite a few questions asking how to use the articulations within EZbass, but not using the EZbass interface. So just to show you what I mean, if we pull in a groove, for example, into the EZbass interface itself, the groove, and then you go to the grid edit, and you can see that there's these certain types of articulations that you can do within the grid edit. I don't use that anymore. What I do is I do everything within Cubase itself now. And I just find it much easier to work that way. So I'm going to initialize EZbass, get rid of all this. And there we have a blank EZbass, and we won't be needing to look at that anymore. So I'm just going to show you how to get all the different articulations within your MIDI editor. As I said, I'm using Cubase, but you could do the same thing within any of your chosen DAW hosts. So the first thing I'm going to kick off with is the slides. So have a quick listen to these. And they're basically, there's the MIDI editor. They're basically being controlled by key commands. So you can see that I've got a bunch of notes. That's the slide down there at the beginning. And a note to finish it off at the end. It's really straightforward. If you place this particular note, which is an F sharp zero, across a bunch of other notes, you'll get a slide. So I've placed it at the beginning of this little phrase and I've stopped it just before that note there. Take that away, sounds a bit of a mess. Okay, so there's a few ways of doing this, but I like to just make it really visually easy to understand. So you can see that I've made the slide key switch start at the beginning of the first note. Let's zoom in a bit more. And end just before the root note that I want to hear without the slide. And also find it's useful to draw in the notes in between. Same thing goes here. And as you can see, I've started the key switch, which again is F sharp zero. I've started that just before the slide begins and ended it just as final note is going to happen. So here it is. Here it is without. See? So it works quite well. Then we've got quick slide up and quick slide down. That's quick slide down. And that's quick slide up. And these are just single notes. And then they have the key switch, which is for down is F0. And for up is G0. You can hear without those. With them. So there you go, there's your slides. Oh, there's your basic slides. Then we've got the joins, or the legato joins, or you could call them kind of slide as well. So have a listen to this. So you can see there, there's a slight difference between the way these parts behave, the second phrase and the first phrase. They're basic notes. So are those. And those two notes are actually being put together like a legato, and so are these. As if you'd kind of hammered on with your finger. And again, it's just a key switch that you put between the notes. Key switch in this case is G sharp minus one. I'll have a listen without. Very subtle, but when it's used carefully, works really well. The other one is Harmonics, and I've done a little demo of that. So with Harmonics, again, we have a key switch. There's a normal note. And then the key switch is there, which is A sharp minus one, will turn Harmonics on. So without the key switches, you get this. And with the key switches, bring out those harmonic notes. Don't forget, we've kind of got a microscope on this at the moment because we're listening to it without any music, anything else. There will be some drums in the next few bits, but you really are inspecting this quite carefully. And when you hear this within music, it will sound amazing. Also, I'm using a very basic bass sound with no kind of distortions or compression or anything crazy on it. Okay, let's go to slaps. So don't forget, I haven't touched EZbass while we've been playing this. I haven't changed anything, and I'm still maintaining that. I'm not going to change anything. So here, let's have a listen to some slaps. Okay, so that was slaps. You can see that it was turned on halfway through the phrase, or actually a quarter way through. Again, it's just a key switch, and the key switch in this case is B minus 1. So you place a B minus 1 underneath your note, and if it's available, you'll get a slap or a pull. Demonstrating both. If we wanted to just do, let's say, that little bit as a pull there, move the key switch. Very straightforward, very simple. Here we have the ghost and mute. Actually, I'm not sure why that's there. It should be there. Have a listen to these. Okay, so this one's a little bit different. It's still a key switch, but basically what you've got here is you've got two different ones. These are the kind of these are the ghost notes, which are on E0. Slightly heavier palm mute sound are on D sharp 0. What it does is that will repeat the last note that you played, but played as a mute. So there's two different ones. There's the lighter ones, which are kind of ghost notes, and the palm mutes, which are heavier. And it's the same two key switches. Regardless of what note you've played, it will play the next note for you as a palm mute or a ghost note. So that, now that's not. Okay. Let's move on to the middle finger. Now, this one's a subtle one, but it's something that actually really makes a difference if you use it properly. Now, I don't know if you can tell the difference between those two sections there while the drums are playing. I've programmed this, so I'm pretty, aware of it. But we've got first half, and one of the nice things, of course, with EZbass is the way that it alternates between fingers when you're playing. So that's just the basic standard. I played that in on the keyboard, and as you can see, I've kind of alternated the velocities a little bit, which is quite normal when you're trying to get that groove going. And then the second half, I've got the key switch there for the middle finger, which is C#0. Now, that section and that section, the notes are identical. The velocities are copied there, that, there to there. And have a listen to the difference. Very realistic. First half is very realistic, but it's not what we'd want if we were playing that kind of phrase. You know, it's kind of a semi-rocky, I don't know, straight ahead. To me, when you use that middle finger key switch, the C#0, you get a much more groovy effect. Like I said, the first part is very realistic and it sounds like two fingers. So there you go, that's the middle finger. That's another key switch. Right, let's move on. We've got the vibratos and bends. These are not key switches, these are your standard, and I thought I should put these in, even though they were quite obvious, I thought I should put them in, because these are just your standard controllers of the vibrato, which is modulation, CC1, and pitch bend, which is pitch bend. Modulation, pitch bend will give you modulation and pitch bend, just like most other instruments. So we're nearly at the end. There's not really much more to it. Obviously, there's a lot of programming that can be done with velocities and with note lengths and so on and so forth. The final one, the little example of damping. So this is the one really I think that people have been wondering about more than almost any of the others, is the dampening. And basically it's another controller, it's CC67 by default, and the more you increase it, the more dampening you get. This is normal. So there you go. Like I said, I think, to be honest, the dampening controllers, you know, they're really useful. All these little things, you can incorporate them into parts. And the important thing is, I guess, to have those written down. And I'll make sure there's a link to that in the links at the end of the video. So there you go, folks. I think I've got just about everything there. There might be a couple of really obvious ones missing. But basically, the point being that you can do everything within your DAW that you can do within EZbass itself. And that means that you can do what you want with these parts. You can copy them, split them, move them around, so on. That's it for now. Thanks a lot for listening, and I'll see you next time. Cheers.